on table topics.
Thank you, it's a TMOD for the day. I don't know what the tricks on table topics of the day are, but nevertheless, let me try to address the concept of table topics the way it is. And to begin with, I first have a question. One is, what is table topics to you all? And what are the areas of concern that you face in the table topics? And probably going to use the board as well. What are the areas?
Yeah. Spontaneity is more important.
Spontaneity is more important. What else?
Beginning.
Beginning. Okay. So shall I use this part? So whichever is left over, I'm going to. Okay. Spontaneity, beginning.
Awareness about the topic.
I have a handwriting of a doctor, so pardon me. Awareness. Okay. What else? Why do you struggle?
Getting an idea, content.
Okay, fine. So let me try to simplify things.
This is on? Okay, great.
You have this object before you, right? Start describing this object for me.
Gavel.
It's gold in color.
Used in gold.
Wonderful. Okay, it's a gavel. What? Gold in color.
Okay. So it's
a
It's a weapon.
Yellow in color.
Yeah,
used by a president. Only president.
Weapon.
Two cylinders put together.
Mini hammer.
Put together. Somebody told self-defense. Right? Self-defense. Two cylinders.
Put together.
Okay. Two cylinders. Put together. What else?
Mini hammer.
Silence.
Signifies silence.
Symbol of authority.
Order.
Symbol of authority.
Order.
Authority. What else? Order. Then?
Mini hammer.
Mini hammer. Okay. Anything else?
$20.
$20? Who said $20?
President.
President, come on stage. You're not going to speak about anything else other than only $20 and speak on $20. And the gavel.
Right. So $20 and the
gavel. Associate $20 with the gavel. And speak only about it.
So right. So this is a golden gavel which we load up from the DMA portal or website. So it charges $20 at least. So and $20 is like 20 into 70, it will cost around 1,400 rupees. So that is an added amount to the treasury. So which in turn will increase the budget from budget for the month. So that will in turn cost us to increase the guest fee from.
Guest fee from?
200 to 205.
Thanks, Arvind. You good round of applause. Stage and speak on only this being a mini hammer. I'll tell you why. Give a good round of applause.
That is a gavel which according to me looks like a mini hammer, so I can either use it evidence when people really try to, you know, taunt me or something, or maybe I can use it, you know, to just hammer some nail, even just to keep it as a paperweight as well. And
thank you. I mean, give it a good round.
This reminded me of two cylinders. I did not see the second part because the speaker was holding it back, so I couldn't see it entirely. If I had seen this, I would have been seated there because I wouldn't have said it's a cylinder. Having made the mistake of saying this, I was wondering in terms of in volume, how much is this compared to this? If you look at it, the length is about 4.5 times this. But the diameter here is about twice. So I was trying to remember my formula of area into length. There's an R square that comes. Just like if you have one good idea, you can explode it. If that R is there, it becomes R square. Therefore, I would assume that this is more volume than this, though the length is 5 times. Any takers?
Give him a good round of applause. Last less than 5 minutes, you have one object. And if I ask any of you all to come back and try to summarize what's on board, we'll have 50 other things to tell on this. Right? So somebody came and spoke of the dynamics of money, somebody spoke of it being a mini hammer, somebody spoke on the geometry of an object. And if I try to summarize things like, you know, it could be gold in color, the color, the appearance, it could be a symbol of peace, self-defense, something that is used to call for order. We have umpteen number of things that we can say in life. Where do we go wrong? We go wrong because we restrict our thinking. We actually close our thinking the minute a topic is given. The first barrier that anybody faces in table topic is that they start to feel that they're not qualified to speak on anything. And anytime you step on stage, actually you lose the battle even before you walk up to speak. Because you think, what is the world going to think about me? The second aspect that comes across, so first thing is that there is no qualification ever required to speak on anything. It is your assumptions, your perspectives, your views, the way you see it, one. Second thing is that you are close to an idea of coming and speaking. You actually lose out on a table topic even before you step on stage. The minute you start to prepare and tell yourself that I'm willing to go and experiment, you're actually winning the battle. And the third thing you need to remember is that there is nothing like a right or wrong worry. Don't worry about what the world has to think about me. It is my perspective, my view, my thought process. Right? Three barriers. One is you don't need to be qualified to speak on a topic. Second thing is that don't worry about what the world thinks. And third thing is be open to walking up on stage and speaking. And essentially, that defines how a table topic is dealt with and how we can actually explore different things. Another thing I want to pick up from what the speakers did. You actually just need to get started. Once you get started, you will know to digress. You know to pick new aspects. He spoke of cylinder, he told that, had I not seen the bottom, I wouldn't have told it's a cylinder. The next 30 seconds, he went on to prove all that he told, the opening statement was wrong, because he went on to describe cylinder and the R and the length of it, right? So he still substantiated it as a cylinder, used area and geometry to describe what it is. The human mind is such, it just needs that initial fuel or ignition to spur. The minute you're able to ignite it, you will have a chain of thoughts that go. And ideally, the one summary I want to give with all of these things on the board is, we fail in a table topic because, or we fail in speaking impromptu because we believe we just need to restrict our thought process to either looking at it as a mini hammer or looking at it as an object for or calling to order. But actually, there are 1,000 different things that can be told on a given object. And nobody ever stops you from saying that. Right? So the first thing I wanted to demonstrate using this is that once you open up your mind, each one of you in this room actually has the ability to come and speak. And what has been put up on the board is something that has been given to you. It's not something that I've given. Right? So this is primarily the basic concept of a table topic, that you have the world before you, you have varied concepts that you can dive into, all of which is demonstrated here. It's about your ability to think beyond the closed approach that will help you. Okay? So that's done, the barriers are done. Now let's look at before even I could get into the concept of how you could handle some table topics, I'd like to leave you, since it's a club meeting, I want to give you a feedback on how table topics need to be formulated also. More often, there also people go wrong. The first element when we try to formulate a table topic is that a table topic needs to be open-ended. Meaning to say, it should ignite a thought. If I'm going to give this gavel and somebody can speak about geometry, that is creativity. You shouldn't, close creativity while formulating a table topic. Leave a table topic open. So how do people close it? People give questions. Tell me about your favorite movie. Tell me about your favorite color, your favorite destination. You can give that to a guest. They come into the club for the first time, you want to make them feel comfortable. Ask them to speak on their favorite color. But to challenge a member, to challenge them to speak on a topic, you need to give something that is a little open so that they're not answering your question, but they're igniting their creativity in their mind to think differently. to go back home and think I could have said as many things. And also to make them feel that I could take this topic. Maybe I can take a topic at the area, at the club, at the division. Because people fail in table topics in the mind, not in reality. The minute you're able to unclutter that as a table topic master, if you're able to give topics that are open-ended, people are able to speak. Second thing is, don't challenge a speaker, but help him ignite his thinking. People try to define heavy-ended table topics which are so heavy that people feel put off. You should never put off a speaker. You should always aid them to come and speak better on the stage. Sometimes people see the topic and they get scared. I'll tell you how to deal with those topics also later. But ignite the speaker. The third thing is that topic should never be too long. It could be short, it could be a single word as well. Or ideally it should be a sentence or a statement, because you don't need to keep repeating it multiple times. If it's two statements, people don't even get the topic. They don't get the time to think and come. Right? So three things a table topic master must remember is, one, don't have a closed approach to the topic. Don't give questions unless it's for a guest who wants to come up and speak. Give topics which are open-ended. Second thing is, don't challenge or put down a speaker. The topic should ignite their thinking. And the third thing is, it should be framed in a manner that once you hear it, they should be able to remember it and walk up on the stage. You shouldn't have to repeat it the second or the third time for them to think. Those two long statements can actually cut off your thinking. Right? Are we clear? So we're clear on the barriers, we're clear on the concept of table topics and how a table topic master should handle it. Now let's do something different. Do I have a duster? Is it a duster?
No.
Okay. Give me topics. Y'all can give me topics.
Milk versus water.
Milk?
Milk. Milk versus
water. Versus water.
Okay.
Jelly cuts.
Jelly cuts. Okay.
Topics. Give me even tough ones, whatever it is. Keep, get it on.
Our brevity is the soul of wit.
Brevity is
the soul of wit.
Brevity is the soul of wit. The soul of wit. Okay. What else?
Tea versus coffee.
Like too many verses. I don't know. We'll find the verses there. So
love at first sight.
All of that. Yeah.
Love at first sight.
Love at first sight. Okay? What else? Topics. Something that is substantial for, you know. So shall I take this topic, say, every achievement is the result of a flaming heart. This was a district topic. So let me tell you, this was 2007, one of my district contest topics. So every achievement is the result of a flaming heart. Can we take the topic? Sounds tough? Sounds difficult to handle? Every achievement is the result of a flaming heart. Okay? What happens in kind of these topics is that people see the heavy usage of words and they get switched off. They're not even able to actually understand what it actually means. So we have topics like milk versus water, jallikattu, brevity is the soul of wit. Love at first sight, every achievement is the result of a flaming heart. Okay? Now, there are a few ways that. So, one thing is that there is no stringent formula that can be applied to handle table topics. Right? There is nothing like a formula method. If you believe that there's some formula that will solve your problem in life, then aim. But there are some methods and ways that you can look at how you can apply, is what I can leave you behind with. The only way you can go about doing anything is to have an open mind. It's only when you have an open mind that you can try applying these things. But nevertheless, I'll leave you with some methods that you can really start applying. The first thing that you need to do when you get a topic is understand the topic. What people fail to do is understand the underlying meaning of the topic. That's where most of the people fail. They're so close with trying to grab the words in it. Did they fail? So, milk versus water, there is nothing much. Jallikattu, there is nothing much. Brevity is the soul of wit. Somebody explain. What does it mean?
As little words as possible, which makes you feel better.
Yeah. The soul of wit is, if you want to be witty, you need to be concise in usage of words. Correct? It means being sharp, being concise, being apt in speaking, right? Love at first sight. Every achievement is the result of a flaming heart. What does it mean?
Passion.
Your passion.
Flaming is the cat towards air.
Yeah, every passion. Achievement is a, you know, is the result of a flaming heart. Means in life you need to achieve anything, you need to have the burning desire within you to achieve it. So that is something that you first need to understand as to what is the topic about. Not go and try to speak about brevity, and some people will think, if they hear the word brevity, they'll get switched off. There's not in my dictionary, what will I do? So the idea is, before you walk up on stage, understand the meaning of the topic. Right? That's the first underlying requirement. The second thing after this is that there are some ways of handling it. One is the system that I used, wherein you got to think beyond your box, essentially. So when I say a topic like every achievement is the result of a flaming heart, this is what I did in 2007. So that time it was just after some incident, I remembered Mother Teresa. They said Mother Teresa walked on the streets of Calcutta, and she turned the streets turned the city of gutters into a city of joy, and so on and so forth. It is because of the flaming heart. Then suddenly I got Mahatma Gandhi, I filtered in Mahatma Gandhi. You know, so the idea there is very simple. And then you get back, so the minute you understand a topic, so the minute you understand that any achievement in life is because of a flaming heart, any success story, anybody's, from Thomas Alva Edison to Mark Zuckerberg to anybody on earth, you can actually start speaking about. The minute you realize what the topic about is, be it Mark Zuckerberg or be it iPhone's Steve Jobs, suddenly it just opens up your mind. One particular name strikes, it opens up your, so you can actually pick this. This is what I do. Suppose you get such topics on success, failure, on similar things. You have a lot of success stories like that surround you, one after the other. So what normally happens in a table topic is you need to concept of example, pointer. Sometimes some people go on explaining one particular example for 2-3 minutes. That's not how you go about it. So suppose you got every achievement is the result of a flaming heart, I'll probably speak about Mother Teresa for a minute. The next minute I'll speak about Mark Zuckerberg. And finally speak of my achievements and failure and probably look at closing it and say that, you know, I may not achieve all that they want to, but even standing before you and speaking here is an achievement for me, and I believe it's because of the desire to walk up on stage and speak that I am here. And I believe as I walk off from the stage, it is an achievement in itself, and I believe that is because of a flaming heart, and I'll walk off. So the idea is, once you get the key crux of what you want to speak, it suddenly throws open a Pandora's box. So be open to throwing open a Pandora's box. So I'm at 20 now?
18.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so one is, when you get such topics which are generic in nature, you can use this concept of story point example drift, story point example drift. I call it story point example drift. Like, achievement, success, failure, passion, love, etc. You can relate to a lot of people in the world. Give a point, drift, give a point, drift, give a point, drift, and look at how you can summarize it. So even a table topic needs an OBC, opening, body, and a conclusion. You need to summarize it. Okay? The next thing is called people, places, events, incidents. People, places, events, incidents. You want to apply people, places, incidents, you can apply it to Jerry Curtis. You know, what is happening today in Marine Drive, about a number of people who come there and gathered, and incidents that have probably, you know, impacted you. You can go back to speak on the culture of it and how probably you see it as a third person, right? So often, there will be some incident in your life, there will be some person in your life, there will be something that you have connected with, or some object, people, incidents, objects, events. Try seeing whether you can relate the topic to that. I could probably relate that to Jallikattu. Brevity is the soul of wit. Again, what does it mean? It means to say that, you know, you need to be concise. So you can apply multiple. I'll get back to dealing with brevity in the soul of wit. I'll tell you how later. There is a third one, which is called past, present, future. What is past, present, future? Meaning to say, speaking of something in the past, present, and the future. Now, everybody does it literally. That's not what it calls for. You know, say love at first sight. I try doing a past, present, future with love at first sight. Now I'm trying to actually engineer this bit. You know, has a little boy always heard that, you know, love happened at first sight? The minute I saw a girl in high school, I thought I was in love with her. But 6 months down the lane, I saw another girl and I felt I was in love with her. And I was always confused as to what love was. When I grew older, I realized it was not love, but infatuation. Until I met a girl in college, I saw and I felt that I really liked her. And I saw her again, I felt I liked her again. And I realized that she had a boyfriend, but I still liked her. And probably that was when I realized that this was my first love, this is my love at first sight. But when I went and proposed to her, all she did was turned away and walked off. And I realized that it's sometimes not enough to fall in love at first sight. You need to be more sensible in making decisions. Having said that, Toastmasters, I have never given up on the concept of love. I'm still madly romantic of falling in love again and again. And I'm sure the next time I see another pretty lady, I would still fall in love with her at first sight. Be a romantic at heart, be yourself, love life, and you'll find the world to be a better place to live in. What have I done? I'm just actually applying. To it, and I've spoken on the topic. Nobody realizes that. That's a different story. But you're actually trying to do a chronology of time, right? On your personal experiences and the chronology of time as to how you could go ahead and you could not, right? And finally, the fourth tool. So the first one I told you is point example drift, depending on the concept. If it's passion, it is failure, success, you can try doing this. You'll have 1,000 characters. The minute you get one character, you'll get the remaining characters, you'll be able to put them in place. The second thing I told you was about?
Place.
People, places, objects, events. The third one was?
Past,
present, future. Use it smartly, you'll be able to, nobody will even realize you've used it.
Okay.
And the fourth thing is called agree, disagree, moderate. Perfectly works here. Milk versus water. The first thing that ever a child drinks is his mother's milk, not even water. And therefore I believe it's mother's milk that actually defines our life. And therefore milk is something far more valid than water. And often it is not seen as it is. Having said that, our lives, we cannot sustain living just on milk. I'm thirsty now, doesn't mean I can keep running for milk and having it today. The only elixir that could probably quench our thirst is water, and water alone. And that is something that is available. Unfortunately, today even good water costs us, costs us money. But that is how life has evolved. We understand the value of water only when we are in the middle of the sea and don't have a drop of water to drink. And the conflict between milk and water can continue for time and again, but what we need to realize is that when milk is needed, and when water is needed. We really shouldn't get into the concept of trying to compare the two, because each has its own value and should be respected for the value that it has. So I spoke on milk, I spoke on water, I tried to moderate both and leave it open. So when a topic is given, you can agree with, say perception matters. You can agree with the topic, you can disagree with the topic, and you can smartly do a articulation of both views and again leave it behind. Right? So agree, disagree. So when a topic is given, sometimes people feel you have to agree on the topic and speak. There is no necessity ever in life that you need to agree on a table topic given in a district contest. Go against the topic for all you know. Or try doing a turntable on the topic and leaving it halfway through. All of these things are possible. So, finally coming to this topic, brevity is the soul of wit. Now this topic will probably leave you confused. The soul of wit, I've always believed I'm a person who's never short of words, and I believe I keep dragging myself and therefore never learn to deliver wit. But through the years I realized that I've never paid for having spoken more, and I realized that the less I speak, people value me more for what I am. And therefore, I need to learn the art of reducing the way I speak. Now, it's something that I probably, if I want to apply, people, places, events, try to relate to people who are paid for what they speak, and you will find a lot of people who are paid for the money that they speak. Or you try to apply, being concise in what you need to do. Apply to situations or apply into life where you probably look at books and say, when you probably write a long Facebook post and you have 1,000-1,500 words, nobody's going to read it. But if you have a single three-liner page and you're submitting a synopsis for something, is where people try to connect with it. Right? So the idea there is to tag on to something. Some topics like this will never give you an idea of what you can tag onto. Sometimes you won't be able to tag onto people, sometimes you won't be able to tag onto objects. In such cases, try to understand the meaning of that particular topic, try to connect it with your personal element, and see if you can do a past, present, future, and get along. So these are few areas that you have to maneuver yourself around and see how you can work. As I told you, there is no magic formula there in speaking. The idea is never to get stuck onto the topic, whenever to think of brevity or wit, and then see what can I speak of brevity, I don't even understand its meaning and feel stuck. Look at how, you know. So the next thing on wit is, you know, stand-up comedians are able to pull off wit because they have their punchlines which are short and sharp. The minute you connect to stand-up comedy, then you'll have 100 different things. The idea is you have to find that one latch that you'll be able to latch on and you'll be able to drive this forward. Any questions, any queries? I know I'm running tight on time. Yeah.
People often go with the topic and they just go on.
Yeah, that was there on my sheet. One thing I wanted to tell you is that often what people do, they pick one word from the topic and they digress when they're closing it. They don't know how to close it also. Always understand the meaning of the topic and, you know, please speak on it. Sometimes like a topic like brevity is the soul of wit. Many people not understand, they'll start speaking on wit and they'll get lost in this whole thing. In cases where you don't understand the topic, you know, you can say ignorance is bliss. I believe it's blissful not to know what the topic is. And then you pull it off. I've done it in the past. So it's being witty, you know, and that's the way you can pull it through.
Is it recommended that you repeat the topic in the mandatory?
Never.
I've heard it said both of you, therefore, thank you.
Never. No repeating a topic. It's actually trying to bide time and the audience can make out your biding time. I don't believe in that. No repeating topics. Topic is repeated twice for the audience to hear, twice for the speaker to hear. You have no reason to repeat the topic. It's just your way of trying to, your defense mechanism. Yeah, any other questions, queries? Yeah? I hope you had some learning from what I had to share here. I had a nice time doing this. I think we're running tight on time. Thank you so much, and it's back to you.
This morning, and he had a session before an emergency. He completed his lunch in 10 minutes and he was ready here in another 10 minutes. So he was fully back and he's leaving to Bangalore at 5:30 today. So, very big round of applause for him. So, to recognize our guest speaker, I would like to invite our immediate past president, Toastmaster Mohan, and our area director, Toastmaster Sunil Jos, on stage.
Discussions and concepts related to life in Bangalore. I have my shows. So I have the videos up on YouTube. So those who wish to can go watch on concepts related like tackling failure, perception, or decoding emotions. Do get the time.